So hi all, good afternoon. It's good to catch up with all of you after a quick lunch. So this is the last session, as I was mentioning, of the digit training. And the topic that we are focusing on today is how digit is extended to satisfy one of the use cases by our client. And the case study that we are focusing on is eChalan. So this topic on eChalan case study is going to be handled by Ghansham and Satish P. So yes, over to you, the both of you. So I'm going to stop screen sharing so either Ghansham or Satish can pick up from here. Thank you. So it's all yours, Ghansham, I guess. Yes.
Thanks, Abhishek. Hello, everyone. So let me present my screen. You can see my screen?
Not yet, Ghansham. I think we will give it some time to...
Right. Abhishek, is it visible now?
Not yet, Ghansham.
Wait, let me reshare.
Yeah, it's just coming in now. Yeah, you can see it now.
Okay. So this session is all about how we can build something on top of it. Okay. So I'll take you through what we have already built. I mean, I think Well or something. Somebody has built that. Satish, who built this module? eChalan. Sorry, Satish, your voice is not clear. Well or
still not clear? Well.
No. Bit noisy.
Yeah. Let me try connecting from my this. So I'll.
Yeah. So some of our partners has built this module with the help of the help what we had provided was about the design, the thought process, how to break down any big problem statement into the smallest problem. And then start thinking about how we should build a scalable module which can leverage the digit also. Although you can build the way you want to build on top of digit, but we want to keep our partners to focus on the scalability part also, so that the module or the service what they are building should not become the bottleneck for the other modules. Okay. So the requirement what we had is the ad hoc payment wala. Okay, so we had that requirement that we need to capture the ad hoc payments from the citizen in the form of the channel. So let's say they will say advertisement, holding advertisement payment, parking payments. We cannot build modules to capture all of these requirements. We cannot keep building the modules. So what we thought of, okay, there can be a generic service which can handle the ad hoc payment. Now, the thought process goes like this. First, this is what we will receive. Okay. This is what we need. Where employee should be able to generate the challan for a citizen, and then citizen should be able to make the payment for that. Okay. Now we need to break it down. The first thing what they are asking for, the challan, right? Second thing is the payment for the citizen. Okay. Then challan, when we are generating the challan, challan must be capturing some of the field. And one field by default comes in your mind that there will be some category of challan, because we want to enable the challan capturing thing for everyone. It can be parking, advertisement, boarding, or anything, right? So the category will be there. Now for that category, there might be some calculations, okay? The charges defined for, let's say, hoarding are different than parking charges, right? So we will have that piece also. So certainly we need to break it down, okay? And then you will come to know, okay, there is a payment part, then there is a calculation part, then there is a field capturing part, okay, where you need to capture certain field. And on a high level, I'm telling you, this is what by default you will understand. Okay, with this much requirement, okay, this is what we need. Now, once you get into the details, you sometimes find that, okay, they want to capture two or three more fields. For example, they want to collect some parking charges. Now you want to identify for which parking you are collecting the payment. Now there can be a GSTN number you want to capture. Based on the category, you may end up capturing some of the extra fields, right? So even though that all of that was not there in the requirement, there was no calculation. So what they were saying, there is no hard and fast rule to calculate any taxes or anything. We just capture the amount in the front end itself. Okay, fine. So we said, okay, fine, no problem. But still, when we design the system, we focused on certain things. First is, it should be able to perform some service-specific validations. Service-specific in the sense, let's say we are capturing advertisement payment. Then if there is anything specific validation or anything, even though it is not there, we should be able to do that. And then provide capability to capture the unique identifier so that you can identify the entities itself for which the challan is getting generated, right? And then in future, let's say if they want to expose the application to the citizen itself, for example, you want that citizen, even though it doesn't happen in India, but you want that citizen want to generate the challan by themselves, not an employee need to forcibly generate that challan and on the name of citizen, and then citizen will make the payment. But citizen is itself want to generate a challan, make the payment, and let's say they want to generate submit that challan somewhere. Okay, like currently, if you have seen the AAMS renewal, license renewal process, what we do, we go to bank, get the challan, submit the money into the bank and take that challan, and that we submit into the police station or the DM office, right? This is how we do. So that also potentially can be done in future. And in case they want to enable the workflow on top of that, okay, after certain approval, the challan will get generated. That capability should not be taken away. We should be able to do this enhancement without impacting the current design, without impacting the current UI, what we have, right? So these capabilities be kept in mind and then design the system accordingly. So what we came up with, okay, there is a challan, there is going to be a challan service which will handle the your unique identification thing, which will handle the workflow integration, even though it is not there currently, but in future, if they need, I know, I will not need to change anything except I need to integrate this e-challan service to the workflow service, right? And then we have this e-challan calculation service. Even though it is not doing the calculation currently, but we kept it for future purpose. If tomorrow they will say, okay, for this particular category, we don't capture the amount on front end itself, rather than it should get calculated from the back end. And ideally, the e-challan system should work in that way. Let's say we are saying, I'm giving you a challan for not wearing helmet on two-wheeler vehicle, right? That is the fixed amount should be configured into the backend system. That should not be a policeman who is sitting there. If you argued with them, and instead of 500, they are putting 1,000 rupees, isn't it? So in future, we know that thing will come anyways. So the calculation service we kept as an dummy service, which is just taking that input, whatever amount getting entered onto the front end through the e-challan service and integrating with the billing service. So this service, e-challan service, is not integrating with the billing. But before that, I just want to go back a little bit. At the first point, when you think about, if you know Digit, okay, there is a payment, there is a bill generation, and what else is there in e-channel? Why can't I generate the bill directly into the billing service and collect the payment through there? Quite possible, right? That's how ad hoc payments work. And this is very much possible, okay? But we are not getting these capabilities there, okay? Whatever we are talking about currently, there is not going to be any workflow, because ultimately what you are doing from the front end, we are capturing the amount detail along with the tax sets and then generating the demand. And then we are generating the bill, calling the bill API and collecting the payment for that, right? So that is not going to be in future, whenever we will get a new requirement, that won't work. Then we are touching the core services directly. But if I'll get any business logic to be implemented today, I don't need to go to billing service, ask for any enhancement. I can do it here itself in each alarm service, right? And then to make it scalable, we follow the same principle. We persist it asynchronously. Okay, we process that asynchronously completely and generate the unique number and return back with the unique acknowledgement number to the client, saying that this is your acknowledgement number for the challan. And then we put it onto the Kafka queue. From there, each challan calculation service pick up that event and calculate the amount if applicable. If not, then anyways, that request is carrying those amounts. So it extract that data and then generate the demand into the billing service and create the bill for that, and then send the notification to the notification service saying that send it to the citizen so that they can make the payment online. So this is the whole process of how we can capture the e-challan detail, and that more of like become your e-challan module itself for future requirements also. Okay, here is the API contract for the same. Sorry. Right. So this is the e-challan system. We have create, update, and search API. So we want to generate the challan, which is create challan. And sometime we need to change the challan details in case they make the wrong entry or something. And then sometime we search the challan also. Now, what all attributes we actually capture here? The tenant ID, and this ID is read only. So we are generating on the server side. And we are capturing the citizen information, the mobile number on whose name you want that challan to be generated. And then business service, the category of for which you are generating the challan. Then challan number, again, we are generating on the server side. This is says read only is equal to true. Then reference ID is nothing, is the unique identifier in case if you want to capture that. This is going to be a unique identifier for your challan. because chalan number we are generating on the server side. So from the, let's say, GSTN number or anything, and any description and the account ID for which user we want to attach that. Anyways, this is not the input from the front end. It is going to be more of like the population based on the user info. Okay. And then additional details may what we capture is extra fields if they want to capture anything. Then status we kept it here for to support the workflow and all in future. Application status, then the source, I mean, in from which channel they are using, let's say WhatsApp, IVR, or some other web app or application, mobile app. Then we capture the amounts. This is, we are keeping it optional because there can be two types of cases. One is based on the category, we can calculate on the backend side, or based on the category, we can capture on the front end itself. So we are capturing the tax head and the amount. And then address, it is again non-mandatory, may not be applicable. For example, if you are collecting the vehicle challan, you don't need the address, you need the vehicle number, right? And which will go as a reference ID here in this here we will have the reference ID as vehicle number. Okay, so address can be optional. And then audit details are we all of us. So this is the minimum number of fields what we are capturing, and we kept a minimum number of fields as mandatory so that that can fit into the all of these use cases. But in case any category wants any particular field to be mandatory, then they can write their business logic within the e-challenge service and then use that for validation purposes. Okay, so I have written certain details of each service, what I have already discussed. Each Alan service, the contract I have showed you, this the capabilities are given, create, update, search. Then calculation service is a Kafka consumer. This is listening to the each Alan service event based. And if it is applicable, we can configure the calculation slabs, rate slabs. If it is not, then it can extract it from the request itself. And the payment part, now the second part is the payment. So we have done till now, okay, challan is generated, bill is generated now. Now payment. Now payment, clearly we don't need to do anything. The digit has the common pay feature, where if you go to that and search for the bill, and based on that you can make the payment. This is generic, so we don't need to do anything for that. And then notification, we send the notification for bill generation with the payment link. And then citizen, we captured these details, and it is non-mandatory, by the way, because it may not be applicable for each category. Yeah, in demand system, we are keeping the consumer code as the challan number. So whatever challan number we are generating, we are keeping that as the consumer code within the demand. So for that challan number, based on that only, you will be able to make the payment. Even let's say tomorrow we want to enable the partial payment, then that has to be on the challan number itself, because that is the only unique identifier which is mandatory we are generating on the server side. Anyways, but reference ID we cannot use because it is non-mandatory and it is not applicable in each category. So we chosen to keep the challan number as the consumer code, unique consumer code, to identify each bill uniquely. So partial payment, advance payment, if it is a recurring kind of ad hoc collection, then we can use the challan number itself or something. Okay, so yeah, this is all about the e-challan system. This is the thought process journey of how to build a new module on Digit. We are using the existing capabilities of Digit, like billing service, to generate the demand and bill. And then we are using collection service for capturing the payment, and we are using PG service for online payment enablement. Notification we are using for sending the notification. User service we are using as a citizen registry, whatever mobile number and name we are capturing. So that, because since this is the PII data, so all data will be encrypted and stored into the user service itself. We cannot have that PII data to be stored within the e-challan service. So yeah, I can take some questions if you have. Sorry, Abhishek.
Yes, Ghanshyam. We'll just give them a minute to see if they have any questions. Okay, there's the first question which has popped in by Mr. Nitesh Sharma. Which tool are you using for drawing sequence diagrams?
Map sequence. So there is a tool called map sequence diagram. This is the map sequence diagrams. If you type .com, it will open. You can see my screen?
Yes, Ghanshyam, we could. Yes.
Yes, this is the one we are.
There seems to be no other question. Satish, you want to pick up the next session?
Yes, Abhishek. I am audible now, right?
Yes, you are audible now, yes.
Okay, let me start presenting my screen. Abhishek, I hope you can see my screen.
Yes, we can see your screen, yes.
Okay. Give me a second. Only this tab is not opening. Give me a second. Okay, in continuation with what Ghanshyam has explained. So Ghanshyam has explained the architecture and the technical part of what has been done in the e-challan as an extension, right? So we had already had a collection, billing and collection service, where the bill, the BEL team has added the e-challan services, okay? So it was actually built as a co-creation. So when I say co-creation, the design and development, the design as well as the requirement was given by, we helped actually. So EGOV has helped on the designing as well as giving the requirements and reviewing the requirements as well. And also as a co-creation from starting the development till the deliverables, we have helped them in the terms of technically product-wise as well as engineering process-wise. So how to run the sprint planning, how to plan, how to release it, what review has to be done, what kind of code review has to be done, all those guidance as an advisor, we were helping the Bell team to for the complete process. Okay, so now you can see here. So what is the, this is basically the step-by-step, the what and all we have done as part of the process as e-challan, while doing e-challan development by the Bell team, is the process which is listed. So the input for starting this, the e-challan services, building the e-challan services is the PRD and user stories, which is basically EGO product owners as involved in writing the PRD and user stories, okay? And there are multiple review sessions with the Bell team. The Bell team was building this e-challan service for the cantonment boards, or the defense ministry. where they add the multiple session with the cantonment boards, and then we finalize the requirements. When the requirements were finalized, then, so as I mentioned, the walkthrough of the PRD and user stories was shared with the partners. The partners here is the Bell team, where we add a series of review and discussion, okay? And then we finally come to a conclusion and finalize the requirements after the Bell has got the sign off from the defense and ministry, and then we started freezing the requirements. When the requirements are frozen, what we started is, the Ghanshyam was presenting one of the documentation, right? So the documentation which he's presented is this one. Give me a second. I think this click is a problem here. Okay. Yeah. So this is the documentation which Ghanshyam was presenting it, right? It was a technical documentation. This technical design was done by Ghanshyam. So yes, we have completed the technical design, and we have shared with the Bell team. So, and also we have done a walkthrough of the same design with the development team, the Bell development team, to make sure that they are in line with whatever we propose the design, and also the design is in line with the requirements. Okay. The next process, what we started is, so we have briefed the Bell team, the partners, because we are working as a co-creation, about what are the process has to be followed and what has to be done in terms of delivering this to the end customers. Okay. Then once this is done, what we have done is, step by step, you are handholding them, because they were the one developing it. Initially, what they have taken is, they have taken the complete design and they have done small customization on top of that, and they rolled out for other modules like PT and water storage. But for this, since this is a kind of a development, full-fledged development, they were building on top of design. So we were helping them in terms of technically guiding, as well as product knowledge, whatever we have, that we are giving the inputs, and also process, because the ego was expertise in handling the multiple product development from the engineering side. We were helping step by step in complete the sprint deliverables. So including the final QA sign off and product sign off, the complete steps we are guiding them. Okay. And estimation and timelines, we have asked them to share it, okay? And then we have reviewed it and make sure that we have a proper timelines and as well as estimation in place to deliver this, the e-challenge service product on time, okay? Then we have breaking out the task, estimation, plan, hello, everything.
Satish, 1 minute.
Yes.
If you're presenting your screen, it's not visible now.
Oh, sorry. Give me a second. So from how long it is not visible?
It's just been the last few minutes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Oh. Okay. Then, where I was there here is the estimation. This is the steps which are listed out here. So you can see now, right? Screen now.
Yes, we can see the screen.
Okay. So I was explaining the 7 steps where we have broken down the requirement is to multiple tasks, and we're given estimation, timelines, and milestones as well for deliverables. So that development went on for almost 2 months. So we had intermediate milestone as well to make sure that whatever developed it showcased to the product owners, and we are getting a continuous feedback. And also we are showcasing to the customer representative so that we are not deviating from the what is the ground reality. Okay. Then we had the complete sprint agile methodology we followed for the development, where we had a backlog grooming, sprint plan meetings, review meetings, all those things. And also we have extended our own Jira, because the Bell didn't add Jira. So we have created the project in the Jira for executing the sprint, the entire sprint plan. Okay. And also there was daily standups. So from ego also, the product owners and the engineering representative used to be there to guide the development team of the Bell and the QA team of the Bell to make sure that they are in line. And also every day we used to have a review of the what is the work done for the previous day and the current day, what is the planned task of the current day. And also the test cases have been written by the Bell team, and we have helped them to review those test cases to make sure that while testing the QA, we're not missing any use cases. Okay, so like this is completely done in such a way that any kind of product development all happens in ego. the similar way this co-creation of the HLN has been executed with the Bell team. Only thing is, when Ego is building it, we'll have in-house team for development and QA, but here the development team was from the partners, Bell team, okay? Then knowledge sessions also arranged whenever required. So since they are building on top of the DZIT, so they had some gaps, like how do we make use of the existing billing surveys, collection surveys, SMS surveys, all those things. So we have given whatever we had in-house team. So we arranged the knowledge transfer session to make sure that they are in line and they understand the DZIT, and then we created an enablement session for them. And this was going on, initially also we done one round of sessions, and also as and when there is a request from the Bell team, we used to arrange the sessions with them, okay? And also sprint review and sprint plan has been done at the end of the sprint, and also incremental sprint demos, which I'm mentioning. So every sprint we used to present whatever we have completed the development and QA, so that we'll get a continuous feedback from the product owners, okay? And also we used to do constant code review where Gansham and other folks from Ego was involved for reviewing the code to make sure that they follow the DZIT principles, the coding guidelines, standards, all those things they'll follow to make sure that we are reviewing it as well, continuously the code developed by the Bell team. And also if there are any changes in between the design, while doing the demo, there can be some input. So based on that, some design might change, or some extra requirement come. So in this case, there was no modified challenge in the initial phase when the requirement was given. Later, they come back with the modified challenge and cancel challenge use cases, where we have went with, again, same kind of review and requirement analysis, and we come up with a better design to support that as well, okay? So as I mentioned, the complete development of QA was done within 2 to 3 sprints. So it's one. So each sprint was up for 2 weeks. So we have completed this complete exercise in 6 to 8 weeks maximum. Okay. And finally, once the development and QA was signed off, so it was deployed in UAT after the QA sign off is done. The UAT meant here is the UAT of the cantonment board. Okay. And also, the incremental demo has been given to the Ego product owners. I was given the demo internally in our sprint showcase, as well as this demo was given to even the clients to have a proper UAT, user acceptance testing has to be done on the UAT, okay? Once everything was done, what we had done is, we have, since this was built by the partners as a co-creation, in their environment, finally, we thought of taking this as part of the product. So our DZIT product roadmap. So we have requested the Bell team to contribute it back. So because they have developed it with our guidance as a co-creation, they have created the Git account in the name of Bell, okay? And they have contributed the code, entire code to the DZIT, where we have taken that and then we have released that, the HLN as a standard product offering as part of the DZIT, so that right now the HLN is there in the DZIT also. And also any enhancement which are going after the HLN contribution is taken back will be available for even Bell and other any outside world as well, because we are an open source. So that any upgrades which the Bell is doing will have all the changes or enhancements which were done in our from Ego also will be available for them. So that's the reason we have taken that as a contribution. And this code is not managed just by Bell team. Now it is part of the standard DZIT product, okay? And so these are the steps which details about how the PR process has been done. So we asked them to write the PR with all the configurations. Sorry. So we have asked them to contribute it back, the entire code, configurations, everything, so that we have reviewed it and we have done QA from our end. On top of that, there are a few documentation which were missing from their end. What we've done is we added a documentation. So here we added a documentation which is available openly for everyone, docs.digit.org, where we added each challenge service documentation, which includes all the diagram which Gansham has mentioned, and also all the configuration details, everything is included here. So this link is available in the docs.digit.org. So all the configurations, everything is mentioned in this, and also including deployment details, integrations, everything. The same way we written for each LLM service as well. So all the documentations have been written, including configurations. So the links to configurations are also available here. And also we have written UI also, the UI technical documentation also, it is has been added here. So this is the overall process. So the Ghanshyam has explained on the design part, where we help them to design the each LLM. Now I explained about how the development process has been taken care as a co-creation model. Is there any questions? Abhishek,
do we have more content to present, or is this the end of the content?
The content is this much only. Yeah.
So to all the attendees, please feel free to ask your questions in the chat box and the QA box as well. Oh, okay. We have one question by Mr. Nitesh Parmar. Is the product roadmap shared on the website? Yes, it is.
Yes,
on
I think we have product roadmap in the website. There's some roadmap here.
Digit dot.
Yes, I think. There's a product roadmap available here, yes.
Yes.
Okay. Any other questions?
We'll give them a minute, I suppose. So, okay. But one thing I have to be honest, in the past 3 days, the more I've learned about what microservices architecture is and Digit, kind of becoming a huge fan of how you can use, reuse most of the components and kind of extension of capabilities also is becoming interesting here.
So now, so even this is just a one example of what is the extension we have that partners have built. And we have similar examples from PwC and other partners also built. And also recently what we have done is we have built one more the platform called iFix platform. So where we have built an exemplar, MGram server exemplar application for Gram Panchayat of Punjab, where we have used, reused all the services of the DigiZ. On top of that, we had to spend only little effort on the customizing on top of the DigiZ which we have built for Urban. Now we have taken that to our the even Gram Panchayat as well. That's another exemplar which we have built.
So the first time effort is not going for waste. So I can start reusing that first time effort as and when we move forward and new use cases are discovered and state requirements come up. So this is interesting. I mean, this is something which I will pick from this training in the past 3 days. Yes. Okay. I don't see any questions coming forward. But yes, this was an engaging session as well. Thank you, Ghanshyam. Thank you, Satish. So to all the attendees, you have our email addresses. Please feel free to write any questions, queries, or any support that you folks need. And a kind request, we request all of you to please access docs.digit.org. I will put the URL here as well, where you can learn more about what we've discussed in the past 3 days and also gain access to the demo account of Digit. So you can play around internally as a team and kind of see what how things work. And you know, any questions, we will be more than happy to support you folks. So on that note, Ghanshyam and Satish, we can call it a day then.
I think, yes, there are no questions. Yeah. I think we can,
Okay, perfect. Thank you all for staying with us for the past 3 days. It was enjoyable. We loved it from here at eGov, and I hope all the participants have enjoyed the sessions as well. And yes, look forward to further conversations through the year and have a great time ahead. Stay safe. And yes, let's all work together. Thank you all.
Yeah, thank you, everyone. Yeah.